New Bern, Connecticut, the home of Little Poland. My name is Lucian Pavlak. I'm fortunate enough to be the current Democratic Registrar of Voters for the city of New Britain. Previously, I'd served as mayor from 1995 to 2003. I was born in a coal mining village in Belgium. We were DPs at the time, as they called us, displaced people. My father, after the war, had a choice of going back to Poland that was devastated, or moving on and trying to get to America. He signed a contract to work in the coal mines in Belgium, and from there we applied for visas and actually waited 11 years to get a visa to come to the United States. A nice way of saying it is displaced person, but when I remember far too often being called a dumb Polak, it wasn't easy. People targeted immigrants, and just like they do now, and we were lucky to have a large Polish community. I remember getting thrown into a two-family home with seven other families living in it. I remember living in one room where my parents would sleep in chairs, and my brothers and I would occupy the bed. The assimilation part was also something that my dad stressed. You know, you have to become an American. And, you know, I don't hear that often in our immigrant communities now. I remember to this day my dad saying to me, at home you speak Polish, out there you speak English. I ended up going to New Britain High School and being a pretty successful athlete, and I played football, and I actually ended up getting a full scholarship to Wichita State University. I drank pretty heavily from the time I was 15 to about 30, and I'm fortunate that I went into a rehab facility and kind of cleaned up my act, and as they say, the rest is history. You talk about Little Poland, and it's no mystery. It's documented. We had a crime wave. We had five active gangs in New Britain. People were telling me they were skipping church because they were afraid to go up those stairs, not knowing what to expect when they came out of church, not knowing whether their cars would be vandalized in a parking lot, not knowing whether they'd get their pocketbooks ripped off. In 1995, when I was elected mayor, my priority was to chase those bad guys out of town. Mayor Stewart, Mayor O'Brien, and Mayor Stewart continued the project. It took a total of 19 years, but it's finally done. During that time, businesses moved in, restaurants moved in, people gained confidence, and it's been a destination place ever since the place got cleaned up. All those years that people call me a dumb Polak, I became stronger because of that. I wanted to prove to them that I wasn't a dumb Polak, that I wasn't a achiever, that I could do stuff. When I was mayor, we used to talk about New Britain, Connecticut, the home of the American dream, and boy, I tell you, I've lived it.